Reporting each other. Make sure you can get a pretty good look at this. Of course, you want to have this material here. This is good to have for you. It's our little project course guide, and this is what we're doing tonight. So, not facing me. That's right. That's right. Please go to my SD card. I don't have any room left. Okay. How do you take video? Who's holding it like this? Knock it off! Hold it like this. The first thing you want to do is hold it in landscape mode. Now let's face it, most of the time when you are looking at video, you are either looking at it on a TV monitor type situation, which is landscape mode, or you're looking at it on your phone on YouTube. In either case, it's always landscape presented to you. If someone is holding your phone like this, and they put it on YouTube, or any other kind of media, World Star Hip Hop, whatever. It's got that annoying side, is all fuzzy, or it's a black bar on the sides. It looks terrible. Landscape mode. That's number one. Allow me to write it down. Landscape. Now, it's your phone. It's expensive. They're getting better. They're getting tougher. No, I know. But no, seriously. No. How much did this thing cost?
A lot.
Yeah. Way too much. If you bought it on the open market, you're like, this expensive as shit. Hold it with both hands. And, you know, pinkies up so that you don't get them in front of the camera. I always do that. I know it looks silly, but you know what? I would rather look silly than have a broken phone. I fucking love my note. It's such a So, you're holding it landscape. Okay. Next. This is about how you actually get the video. Normally, we all kind of do this sort of thing, don't we? Like, one hand. I mean, I even do this every once in a while. I have kids. I've got tons of videos of my kids on Facebook and on YouTube. You can totally find them. They're adorable as shit. However, that's bouncy, isn't it? If you're taking video, you're actually taking the time out of your life instead of just watching the fucking thing happen. Instead of watching the interesting event, you're actually paying attention to your phone and recording the event. That's what you're actually doing. It doesn't matter if the event's happening on the screen in front of you, you're still recording it, and that's what your mind is going on. So if you're gonna do that, you may as well get good footage. That way, at least you can look at it again later, or whoever you wanna show it to can see it without getting seasick. So, you have your both hands on there, elbows in. Elbows in. That's right. Let your elbows touch your rib cage. It's good. This makes it a lot more stable. In fact, you probably have already noticed it's more stable by having your elbows in. Landscape. Command. Elbows in. Additionally, since you're taking footage, you're probably not moving around a heck of a lot. I'm willing to bet you're standing in one place. If you're recording the football practice so that you can review plays, which we do, and we actually do this. We actually can get your hands on the cameras. We can put a laptop out there with Dartfish on it, that kind of stuff. You're not moving around a heck of a lot. You're probably following the ball. You don't want to do this to follow the ball. Bouncy. Makes you sick. Think like you are a camera tripod. Elbows in, two hands, securely held. Turn with your core. Go ahead, turn with your core. See how nice and smooth that is compared to moving it with just your hand. When you move it with just your hand, whips around a lot, bounces up and down. When you turn with your core and you're holding with both hands, you're even, you're well spaced. You can move smoothly and fluidly because you've got more core muscles. It's so much easier to do and it looks better. So, turn with core. Right? Cool. Next, I have a glance. So, your phone and every other camera out there, all of them have this fisheye lens effect. I'm not sure if you are familiar with it, which means that the edges of everything gets bent and turned because, I mean, if you look at your camera on here, It's a little bead, isn't it? It's a round bead. That means the edges of the screen are always going to be kind of skewed and bent. Now, the technology is getting better, or getting better at removing most of that, but it never really goes away. The center of your screen is always a better picture than any other part of the screen. It will always be that way with the kind of cameras that we have. As such, try to keep your subject within the middle 75% of the screen, right? You want to try to keep people in there. So there's a little margin on the outsides of about 7.5%, right? 7.5%. All the way around, you're estimating it. Some camera phones, my phone has a grid, so I can actually see where the best portion of the screen is. Again, my phone's better than yours. So 75%, you want to stay within that center mass. Center mass, 75%. The middle three quarters of your screen. And then the last one's kind of weird. But I bet you can all do it. Last one's just sort of weird. You're taking video. You're getting good video of whatever it is that you want. You're probably not moving around. But you're a human being. You're a dynamic, fluid object. You are mostly made out of water. You are covered in carbon-based polymers. All of us are a little jiggly. Some of us a little bit more than others. We all bounce. Can't help it. Breathe in, we breathe out. Our muscles have to contract, slow twitch, fast twitch muscles are trying to keep that phone stable. But you can utilize what your head utilizes. Your dynamic, take advantage of it. A little bit of a horse stance, right? Feet shoulder width apart, good stable stance. Feet maybe slightly skewed out, depends on your particular gait. Bend at the knee a little bit. I'm not talking like, unless you're like hardcore and you can do it and go for it. Just a little more stance, right? That way you can adjust. You can adjust as you need to. Now this keeps you smooth, fluid, able to turn, able to make quick decisions. That's that horse stance. But let's say you can't. You're tired. It's a rainy day. Field's muddy. You're on an incline. It's gravel. You're in barefoot. Oh, fuck that shit. Become a tripod. So if you can't do the horse stance, you can do something better. Become a tripod. You have two ways of doing that. Number one, get to a wall. Everybody, to a wall. Up here too. Everybody, move. Wall, door, whatever. Right? Now note how I'm standing here. You can do the same thing with the wall. I have my body up, shoulder against the wall. This foot against the base of the wall. Holding like this. I can turn with the core. It's great when you're in a door frame because you can go around the door frame. You can get a really big spread. My other foot is way out over here. So this is my inner foot. Here's my outer foot. I'm creating a triangle, a tripod. Nature's strongest shape is a triangle. It allows us to take all of the energy of our motion and just direct it here, direct it here, direct it here. It's not in the camera at all. Right? So there's that. Your second one. Quick, back to your seat. Quick, run, run, go.
No, you didn't kick my glove.
Your second tripod option. And this one's really good for this class, especially because I want you to take video, I want you to take pictures. You should be doing this in all of your classes if your teachers will let me do it. Is I got a table in front of me, right? Elbow, elbow, belly. I don't need that. But elbow, elbow, sternum. Get into it. Take all the weight of your body off this. I am not putting any of my body's energetic motion into this camera now. It's dead stable. Looks good. I'm taking away my energy. It's going right into the table, making a triangle. You become the tripod. That is the fifth one. Of the most important things you can do So it's tripod or horse. Now those are the things you can do to get good footage. There are some things that you might want to keep in mind. All right? And this is stuff that we will address within our lessons here, especially over here with lighting and staging. Lighting, that's a pain in the ass. If you're outside, you gotta try to keep the sun behind you. The sun will wash out any camera. It doesn't matter how good that camera is. It doesn't matter if you're using one of the professional ones. You got the sun in the frame, nothing. It's just gone. Everything's gone. It's impossible to recover from. And I know, I do this professionally. I recover video and still images that are on ye old, like, actual film, which is higher resolution than any digital camera we have. Old chemical film is still better than what we have here. And I can try and recover some of the image, working in Photoshop for like 9 days straight until my hair starts to grow out again and I'm all scraggly. And my boss says, go home. And I'm like, but I am at home. So I probably am, actually. He's looking at me through WebEx. Stop, just stop. But that happens. I mean, that's the kind of stuff you have to deal with. So take precautions, get it out of the way. Get that sun behind you. Right? So you're doing your tripod, you're leaning against a wall, you're filming a basketball game so that you can work on your plays afterwards. You're filming a client, how they're walking and their gait is outside on uneven terrain. You're trying to help them because they're recovering from ankle surgery. Get that sun behind you. That's this little extra bit here. Lighting. Light from behind. You, behind you. And the last one is sound. Now sound is always a problem. Because sound is something that is oftentimes uncontrollable. You can't do too much about it. Your camera is gonna pick up sound, anything near it, which will include your breath. You might find it very strong on this, you might not, in the video you're taking right now. I'm gonna find it is, because I'm asthmatic, so my breath is very loud. So I'm gonna have to move the camera a little bit further away from my body. But that does make it bounce more. Take that in consideration. When you're filming, especially things like your phone, you can oftentimes turn down the gain on the sound. As I say, it's just not gonna record sound as loudly. That helps. Look in the extra settings of your phone or the camcorder that you're using. Or, if you really want to get into it, you can buy a microphone pretty cheaply for your camera phone. And it uses just the 3.5 millimeter jack right there. You know, a lot of the phones are losing those jacks nowadays, but they still exist. And maybe your phone came with one. Heck, mine did. You know, the phone cord. You plug it in, put it in your ear, but it's also got the little speaker right here so you can talk into it. That works great. Plug it in. Just let it hang down. That way it's not getting you at all. Or plug it in and clip it on or tape it on or something so it's not getting any of your sound whatsoever. That's another little trick. But sound is just an issue. I can't really, there's no real good way to take care of it unless you're really going to go ahead, buy the microphone, utilize a good camera, get a tripod. Fuck, you're already up to like $3,000 of stuff. What can I say? You do what you got. So, this is Project One. Thank you very much, and I'll stop it.